Here's one for you. How can we get a high power charger that only has CCS plugs to charge a Nissan LEAF that only has a CHAdeMO socket? And how fast can we get that Nissan LEAF to charge? Let's find out. Welcome to Plug Life Television. To find out the answer to this, I went to Glen Rothes to visit Electron Garage, an incredible facility that specialises in EV retrofitting and repair. Whilst I was there, I had a chance to catch up with Myla and Doug, the garage's two dogs. We go way back, and these two have previous form when I've been doing filming.
Look who's come to visit today, it's Myla. Oh, yes, that would be my ear, Myla, yep.
In fact, hang on a minute. What am I about to let myself in for? Yes.
Anyway, at Electron Garage, I picked up an Electway CCS to CHAdeMO adapter that the garage had just managed to get its hands on. The plan was to use it on a high-power CCS charger with a 62 kWh LEAF E+, which can allegedly charge faster than most of the UK's CHAdeMO chargers will allow it to. This is because the maximum power that can be delivered by a rapid charger is equal to the battery voltage multiplied by the lesser of the maximum current capability of the car or charger. A 62 kWh Nissan LEAF E+ can allegedly charge its 400 volt battery at greater than 50 kilowatts. However, most of the UK's rapid chargers have a maximum CHAdeMO cable current of 125 amps, which is considerably less than the CCS cable on the same charger. This means that the maximum power that the LEAF can normally charge at is equal to its 400 volt battery voltage multiplied by the 125 amp current limit of the charger, which limits it to just 50 kilowatts. Check out the Plug Life Television episode, Why is my EV not charging at full power on a rapid charger, for more information about this. In theory, if we could harness the greater current available via CCS, the 62 kWh LEAF E+ may charge faster. Before collecting a 62 kWh LEAF E+ to test out this theory, I tried the adapter on my own 30 kWh Nissan LEAF, which stars in its own EV review on the Faster Project YouTube channel. Check it out in the link below. I grabbed the CCS to CHAdeMO adapter from Electron Garage and headed to a nearby high power charger in Glen Rothes to try it out.
So we've arrived at the ESB Charging Hub in Glen Rothes. High power chargers up to 300 kilowatts, they say on the side, and we're going to be using this contraption, a CHAdeMO to CCS adapter, to try and charge a 30 kilowatt hour Nissan LEAF on what is a CCS only rapid charger. So technically this car should not be able to charge on this. So even if we don't get above 50 kilowatts on this, it will still be an improvement because it means that we're going to be able to charge this car at more locations. But it'll be interesting to see if the 30 kilowatt hour Nissan LEAF even attempts to pull above 50 kilowatts. So let's find out.
Right, I couldn't show you me plugging the adapter into the car and into the charger because it would have been one-handed and very clunky. But as you can see, it's trying to get itself ready. I'm hearing a few clunks. I'm seeing some flashing lights on the adapter. Nothing on the LEAF yet. Oh! But that said... Okay, right, so that information there is not right. That's interesting. Because we're definitely not on 1%, we're on nearer 60-something. So, it looks like this is kind of half-working. Gonna need to try and figure out what's going wrong.
So I'm off the phone with Wayne from Electron Garage, who explained how to use the adapter. It's not quite as straightforward as you might think. Sometimes, depending on the charger, it can be a little bit fussy. So what you need to do is plug the CCS plug from the charger into the adapter. There's a little green light on the top that starts flashing. You then unplug the CCS plug from the charger, very quickly put the flashing adapter into the car's CHAdeMO socket, then plug the CCS in. It took me a few goes to get it, but we are now actually charging, which is progress. So this is a LEAF that should never ever have been able to use this CCS only rapid charger, and we're managing to use it. The downside is that it's okay, it's not a bitterly cold day, but it's fairly mild outside, 9°C, the battery's not that warm, and even though the 30 kilowatt hour Nissan LEAF is known to pull a very high charge power right up to about 80% before it starts tapering off, and it doesn't really care about how hot it gets, that cold starting point means that the charging power is a wee bit less than we would have hoped for. We did actually peak at 35 kilowatts very briefly, but it's now down to about 30 or so. Bearing in mind that the car started at about 60% state of charge, as I say, if the battery was warmer, and the state of charge was maybe a little bit lower, then we might have seen higher charging power. But, you know, progress nonetheless. However, word of warning for anyone who's looking to do long distances with a Nissan Leaf using a CCS adapter, it might not always be straightforward. You might need to play about with the order that you plug things in for a little bit, whereas a CCS equipped EV, you would just plug in and that should be it, should be straightforward. But, you know, for people who've got Leafs who like them, this is, it's a crucial lifeline that gets you, you know, further than you would have been before, because it opens up more options for CCS only chargers. So yeah, positives and negatives to take away so far. What will be interesting is when we try this same adapter on a higher power, allegedly higher power Nissan Leaf E Plus, 62 kilowatt hour, which rumor has it can pull at least 70 kilowatts if the CHAdeMO cable can handle it. So let's see if the CCS adapter can handle it too. So we're back at the Glenrothes high power chargers again, and this time I've borrowed a 62 kilowatt hour Nissan Leaf from my cousin Eleanor, who you may remember from Twitter. She's electric. Her account took Twitter by storm in the 2010s. She's been a bit busy with equestrian stuff recently, but she says hello to all of you. Anyway, Eleanor's had this Leaf for a while, and she's very kindly run down the battery for me deliberately so that we have arrived here on 21%. So the battery should be ready to take on as much charge as possible. So allegedly the 62 kilowatt hour Leaf will pull above 50 kilowatts if a CHAdeMO cable will allow it to, but most CHAdeMO cables max out at 50 kilowatts. This CCS rapid charger goes up to 300 kilowatts. So with the help of that CHAdeMO to CCS adapter, let's see if we can get this Leaf to pull more than 50 kilowatts on a charger that it was never designed to use. It's done it again. Same 1% when we're definitely not. Aye. Okay, might take a few goes. We've finally got it to start charging using the adapter. Let's see what we get up to. Possibly one of the ways I was able to get this to start charging was I switched the car completely off. I'd previously left it on standby so that I could record everything on Leaf Spy. So what we're going to do is we're going to plug back in again, or switch back on again I should say, and we'll see what we get up to. I'll be logging this charge session on Leaf Spy, so we'll see just how fast it's going to go. So at the moment we're up to 40 kilowatts and we're still climbing. Let's see if we can go any further. We're up to 48, we're up to 49, we're up to 50. Are we going to go? Oh, we're going above. We have a charging session on a Nissan Leaf with a CHAdeMO to CCS adapter on a high power charger, and we are still climbing. Brilliant. This is faster than most Leafs will ever see in their life. And we are still going. This is going to be a shorter lunch break than I thought. 70. This is where most people have said the Leaf caps out. 72. Oh, that's a very sudden. Did you see it? Oh, it had a wobbly there. It's almost like it changed gears, even though that's not what it does. So 73 seems to be where it's happy to sit. As I said, this car would normally never see anything above, whoops, tripping over the bushes, never see anything above 50 kilowatts. So this adapter is a game changer. We're sitting at over 70 kilowatts on a 62 kilowatt hour Nissan Leaf, on, as I said, a CCS charger that it was never designed to use. This really opens up cross-country travel and much faster charging times for owners of 62 kilowatt hour Nissan Leafs. That said, it's not a straightforward adapter to use. It took me about 4 or 5 attempts to plug the CCS plug into the adapter, then unplug it because it woke it up and then it started the flashing thing on the adapter, then plug it into the CHAdeMO socket of the car, then very quickly put the CCS plug from the charger in. The first few times that happened, I got that weird 1% charge thing on the charger, which obviously isn't right, and it quickly aborted the session. Eventually what I did, which worked, was I switched the car off completely rather than having it on the kind of standby screen before you actually properly switch it on. It's almost like you press the start button twice on the Leaf, you know, without having your foot on the brake. So I switched it off completely, which disconnected Leaf Spy, which I really, really hope is recording now. That's going to be annoying if it's not. But yeah, that's what got it started. I've now put the car back on standby. I'm going to check Leaf Spy and see if it's behaving itself. So hopefully we'll be able to get the charge curve from 20% to about 80% on the car. So now that we're kind of approaching the higher states of charge, you can see that the power is starting to taper off and we're now back to more conventional charging speeds, 43 kilowatts, nothing special for a Leaf, but because this is such a novel product and it will be useful for people to know, I'm going to keep this running until the car says it's 80% full and we'll log the charge curve and see what it looks like.
And true to his word, he continued to charge the car, surrounded by friendly woodland creatures.
Wee bud.
The trouble with CHAdeMO versus CCS is that it's not as simple as, for example, an appliances power adapter. You can't just buy a simple adapter that turns a European plugged hairdryer into something that can fit into a UK power socket. There's protocols involved, there's the communications involved, and they are very different between CCS and CHAdeMO. So that's why this adapter's so clever. It's basically got its own inbuilt Duolingo. It's converting German to Japanese on the fly. And that's the only reason that this adapter is able to actually charge the car in the first place. Hooray, that's us. Let's get unplugged. Although it took me about 5 goes to get the charger to start charging the Leaf via the CHAdeMO to CCS adapter, I've just been told by Wayne at the Electron Garage that the manufacturer of that adapter is actively looking for feedback on how to improve charging sessions. They can do firmware updates whenever there are any kind of finicky issues that are encountered. So hopefully, what we've learned today and what we've experienced today will result in a more seamless experience for every owner of that adapter in the near future. So yeah, if you want to be one of the early pioneers and you don't mind the odd, you know, hokey-cokey, you know, put the CCS plug in, take it out, plug it into the car's CHAdeMO socket and then plug in the CCS and all this, you know, if you don't mind persevering with that for a few months, hopefully this will become a properly seamless product. But what we're seeing today is that it fundamentally does work, which is something that we'd previously thought wouldn't be possible because CHAdeMO and CCS are such totally different protocols. And that is a really impressive step forward.
Here's the charge curve from 20% to 80% state of charge for a 62 kWh Leaf E Plus using the Electway CCS to CHAdeMO adapter. Note that the state of charge is taken from Leaf Spy and factors in the state of charge buffers on the car, hence why the charge starts at 30% on the graph. The car took 2 minutes to ramp up to its peak charge power of 73 kilowatts. I don't have data from a comparative charging session on a high-power CHAdeMO cable to compare this with, so I can't tell yet whether this is to do with the car, the charger, or the adapter itself. The peak power was sustained for all of 90 seconds before linearly dropping off, although it did stay above a CHAdeMO cable's usual maximum charge power of 50 kilowatts for just over 15 minutes. The battery temperature increased by about 20 degrees C during the charging session, and actually continued to rise slightly after the car was unplugged and driven away, which shows how long it can take for heat generated in the core of the battery pack to dissipate. That said, it was a reasonably cold day, so the temperature of 31 degrees C reached at the end of the charging session is of little concern for long-term battery health. The total time to go from 20 to 80% state of charge on the dashboard, or 30% to 80% state of charge on Leaf Spy, was 40 minutes. However, if we were to cap the maximum charge power at 50 kilowatts, as per a typical CHAdeMO cable on a rapid charger, and charge the car from 20 to 80% as before, we find that the total time saved by using the CCS to CHAdeMO adapter to boost the maximum charge power is a grand total of 4 minutes. This raises the question of whether or not a CCS to CHAdeMO adapter is really worth it. So let's take a step back and look at these findings logically. A CCS to CHAdeMO adapter opens up hundreds of new charging sites across the UK alone by allowing the likes of the Nissan Leaf to use chargers that only have CCS plugs, such as Tesla superchargers, Ionity hubs, and the ESB chargers that were used in this video. It also lets you skip the queue for the one CHAdeMO plug that's found at modern grid surf sites, which tend to be almost entirely CCS. If you have a Nissan Leaf E Plus, will the adapter save you time on a cross-country road trip? Probably not. That said, if you're doing lots of shorter stops and running down the battery state of charge before plugging in and charging to not much more than 50% state of charge, then those few minutes saved here and there may be useful, especially if you're keeping an eye on the charge power and moving on when it dips below 50 kilowatts. As for cost, adapters such as this Electway example can often cost upwards of £800 unless bought in bulk. If I find some particularly affordable examples, I'll post the link to them in the description below. Controversially though, I'm going to say that these are worth the money. That might sound mad to begin with, but if you have a Nissan LEAF or ENV200 and plan to run it into the ground, then spending close to £1,000 on an adapter is still much cheaper than buying a replacement EV that has a CCS socket. And that goes for anyone, regardless of whether you have an old short-range bargain bucket LEAF from the early 2010s, or the flagship, more expensive long-range E-Plus model, which would otherwise be a serious rival to the likes of the Kia e-Niro if it came equipped with CCS. On top of this, the Nissan LEAF and ENV200 are solidly built, borderline indestructible cars, which I can vouch for having owned two of them and taken them on grueling road trips to remote locations like the Isle of Skye, speaking of which, you can check out that road trip in an earlier episode of Plug Life Television. See the link in the description below. On top of this, the LEAF and ENV200 have excellent aftermarket support from third-party experts and are one of the most reverse-engineered EVs out there, so you'll never be stuck for options to keep these trusty vehicles on the road. A CCS to CHAdeMO adapter helps to extend their lifespan even further. Right, time for some bonus Tesla content. I realised I might be able to charge a Model S using the Electway CCS to CHAdeMO adapter plugged into the Tesla's CHAdeMO to Tesla adapter. I drove a Model S to the Glenrothes high power chargers and tried it out, but no matter what order I plugged the adapters into the car, the charger and to each other, I could not get the charging session to start. This isn't a major issue, since the CCS to CHAdeMO adapter costs about twice as much as Tesla's CCS adapter, which is a much more compact and convenient adapter than the car's CHAdeMO adapter is anyway. On top of this, the maximum charge power would have been limited by the Tesla's CHAdeMO adapter, which can handle a maximum of only 125 amps, which translates to between 35 and 50 kilowatts of maximum charge power in reality. If any other Tesla drivers out there do manage to get a CCS to CHAdeMO adapter to work in conjunction with the Tesla's CHAdeMO adapter, please do keep us all posted in the comments below. That's everything for now. If you end up buying a CCS to CHAdeMO adapter for your LEAF or ENV200, let us know how you get on in the comments below. Bye for now, and see you next time for another episode of Plug Life Television.